information, where in fact Syria's new police chief has pledged to restore full security order. Syria's interim government is trying to restore order and public services following al-Assad's fall. The new administration appointed a former opposition commander as the country's new police chief. He also stated that their fighters are deployed to patrol across Damascus. He in fact also added that they will not rest until full security and order are established in the every part of the country. Major General Sudhakarji, in fact, as you are with me right now, while you were giving so many details about how and in fact what led to this taking over by the HTS, what we know so far is in fact now the new police chief has been appointed, and now the celebration by the Syrians, who are being, a few of them are being partly happy, others are also very tense given how the new political regime is now going to be shaping the future of the citizens. What is in your mind about the developments that are now happening, as you were in fact giving me some peculiar details? You can also pick up from where you have left.
Okay, thank you, Simran. You see, in the second part of your articulation, you have raised three important issues. The first one is what led to the current situation. When you ask about, these are my personal views, Simran, being a student of geopolitics, people may agree, may not agree. I personally feel there is much more than what the eyes can actually see, or there is a global dynamics which is actually emerging. Today, we are talking in 21st century, and we have this is Cold War 2.0. US as a superpower is not been able to assert its authority and supremacy as expected and perceived from a superpower in the 21st century. So US is going all out, in my understanding, to assert its supremacy. No superpower would like to lose its supremacy and authority anytime, anywhere in the world. So keep that in the back of your mind. And second most important thing is it's a transition phase in USA. Elections have been held. Donald Trump is in waiting. He will be going to office by 20th of January. And there is a hues there on either side of the spectrum, the Democrats and the Republic. Democrats, they have an intention to have their pie of flesh or the pound of flesh. Because historically speaking, as a superpower, USA has got a drumming and beating from all over. Talk about Vietnam, talk about Afghanistan, talk about your Libya, Iraq, any place. They have had no logical justification. No logical, except for Korean Peninsula, of course, I would say. That also was at somebody's cost. So they have not come out gracefully from any battle zone or any conflict zone as worthy of its name called as a superpower. So therefore, under the present circumstances in 21st century, look at what has happened in a short time after the Lehman Brothers crisis, financial crisis, which USA went through, or the whole world went through. What all things have happened? You see, prior to that was, you know, 9/11. They went hunting for Osama bin Laden, thinking that he would be hiding somewhere in Afghanistan. And finally, they neutralized him in Abbottabad in Pakistan. And Pakistan was the strongest ally of USA then, until they realized they are being taken for a ride. The Pakistani coming out to a double agent. So all these things put together, if you look at it, talk about the Ukraine, how Ukraine is taking a good hammering from Russia. Russia is fighting against 32 countries. 32 NATO members are fighting, putting their might together against one nation. There also USA has not had any success. In Middle East, they haven't had. If you ask me, Israel is not succeeding. It is creating another set of Hamas. The ideology will never die. Another set of Hezbollah, 10 or 15 years from now, same Hezbollah, same Hamas will come back to actually hit Israel where actually it hurts them. Mm. So to say gracefully, if Democrats have to go out of the present dispensation or the tenure in a respectful manner, perhaps they are going all out to have some kind of a success signal, some kind to remove Assad is a big, big success as far as the Americans are concerned, and putting Russia in a back foot, because they know that Iran, Russia, Hezbollah, they have been actually weakened to large an extent, they cannot respond. Next point I want to highlight is, look at Syria. Syria is the only transit point available between Iran and Hezbollah and Hamas. Everything, men, material, machine, logistic, everything passes from here through Iraq, then it goes to Syria, and from Syria it goes to Hezbollah and Hamas.
All right.
Now,
corridor. All right. Major General Sudhakarji, because I'm running a little short on time, I'll request you to kindly stay on with me.